This is Lion's Ground.
What is that? This is the second time I've seen it.
But something was out there. Triangular object that hovered and then flew off.
July 2nd, 1947. An unknown object crashed on a farm near Roswell, New Mexico. After initially declaring it to be a flying saucer, the US military eventually claimed it was a weather balloon. Over time, conspiracy theories began to be suggesting it has to be an alien spacecraft and that the military had recovered the bodies of aliens and their technology. This incident is known as the Roswell case. That is the beginning of the modern ufology, the study of the UFO phenomenon.
They were said to be in the range of 3.5 to 4 feet tall, rather spindly looking, with very oversized heads and huge eyes. Nothing of the sort resembles one of these crash test dummies.
But a few years before the Roswell UFO crash, a mysterious flying object flew over Los Cantones de Carunya. A married couple who witnessed the event informed their son what happened, who became later a world pioneer in ufology. This is the story of Oscar Rebrea from Coruña. Oscar Rebrea was born in Coruña in 1923. He graduated from high school in that same city, joined the 250th Infantry Division, where 50,000 Spanish and Portuguese soldiers fought with Hitler against the Soviet Union during World War II. This division was better known as the Blue Division. But on the Russian front, he was about to experience something that changed his life forever. February 10th, 1942, outside Leningrad, present day known as St. Petersburg, in Krasny Bor, Soviet artillery began to bombard the positions of the Blue Division. 5,900 Spaniards faced 38,000 Red Army soldiers and at least 100 tanks. More than 4,000 Spaniards died in that battle. At one point, the Spanish saw something that surprised them. They witnessed a disc-shaped ship, remaining motionless, hovering over the battlefield for several minutes until it disappeared at high speed. The Francoists believed it to be a secret weapon of the Third Reich, or Russian observation device, although, as far as we know, neither side had a similar device in their air force. No matter what that was, Oscar is labeled now forever by that experience. After the end of war, he started working at the Meteorological Observatory of A Coruña, where he pursued his main hobby, astronomy, in addition to his profession, until on October 15th, 1945, his parents, along with Coruña, witnessed the sighting of an unknown object above Los Cantones. Again, the sighting was attributed to a new secret weapon related to World War II, which ended a few months earlier. For Oscar, what flew over his city was a UFO, a term that had not been yet invented, similar to what flew over the Blue Division in 1942. He decided to investigate and start documenting sightings, especially of this type. In this way, he became a pioneer and the first Spanish ufologist in modern history and possibly in the world. He began to keep a diary that will become the most comprehensive work of UFO sightings in the world between 1945 and 1964. He worked alone for years, until the 60s, where he shared it with Society of Researchers of the UFO Phenomenon in Spain, which was founded in Barcelona in 1958. Regardless of whether we believe these theories or not, Oscar was not a fanatic or a strong believer. He was always very critical and also very serious researcher on the subject. He debunked many cases of alleged UFOs, showing that they were due to meteorological, astronomical causes or simply hoax, making big enemies as a result of that. He believed in the possibility of extraterrestrial life, but his critical thinking prevented him from validating theories that had not been scientifically proven. He was called by the name Wise Galician by the UFO community and became an authority, regularly consulted by colleagues far more famous than he. His last major investigation may have been that of another famous sighting, this time in Vigo, in 1970, seen by thousands of people and even recorded by a witness, where a highly luminous metal object hung over the city. Oscar, advised by a Jesuit professor from the Santiago Apostle School, analyzed the UFO from the Coruña Observatory and concluded that the unidentified object measures 300 meters and was about 40,000 meters high. Oscar has published his scientific theories in El Ideal Gallego, in prestigious scientific journals, and even in official publications such as the Revista Aeronautica y Astronautica of the Spanish Air Force. And some of his studies outside the UFO field have been candidates for awards, such as the Prince of Asturias. Journalist and writer Manuel Carvajal tells of him that he even sends corrections to Wernher von Braun, designer of NASA's Saturn rocket that will bring humans to the moon, of some of his astronautic math equations, to give you an impression how smart he was. Currently, many of the UFO files that have been occurred in Galicia and all of Spain have been released and can be accessed in the Virtual Defense Library. This is an example of one of the many files that are available for inspection. Oscar Rebreia died in A Coruña in 1973 and went down in history as the first ufologist in modern history in Spain and possibly the world. But above all, he left us a great legacy as a scientist and a rigorous researcher. Subscribe to Lions Ground and share this video.